whatever's going to keep you warm throughout the night here at Federation Square, the official live site for Black Caviar's big moment tonight in England. And no doubt there'll be hundreds here braving the cold conditions in supporting Black Caviar, as they will, I guess, at Black Caviar parties all around town. If you're at home, 11 o'clock, the coverage starts on 7 with Black Caviar's big race, the Diamond Jubilee Stakes, at 12:45. And Jen, while it might be cold here, Black Caviar will certainly be running hot tonight at Royal Ascot.
The year I went to the Melbourne Premier Sales, when I saw Black Caviar, I instantly fell in love with her.
Out to 10, done, well done. Oh, Peter Murty, thank you very much, Pete. Very best of luck with that filly.
Black Caviar, she's three lengths in front and did it very, very comfortably. Shaken up now by Noski, she put four lengths on them. Demerit's running on okay, followed on the rails by Carrara, but she's just as impressive here at Caulfield. Black Caviar under a hole, won it by five lengths. She is a real find. 300 metres now, and Black Caviar is coasting. Kicks away, 2 to 3 lengths on Crystal Lily. King Pulse beaded is coming home. Black Caviar away by 4 lengths with 150 metres to go. This is unprecedented, 10 straight. Black Caviar by 4, Crystal Lily is beaded, but she is unparalleled. Black Caviar, perfect.
Black Caviar is pulled to the centre of the track, but he's giving Haylist, or she's giving Haylist about 4 or 5, and then came Hinchinbrook. It's Haylist in front. Black Caviar, she's starting to knuckle down to the task now. Here she comes, Black Caviar. She raced up and hit the lead, and the Black Caviar, the best in the world.
Fast, but she takes over the running now, Black Caviar, and kicks away. This is the great exhilaration we come to see. Into the straight she goes, and if you've come to see the greatest, here she is. Black Caviar opening up by about 5 or 6 lengths. 300, and Hayless clinging on narrowly. But now here comes the great mare, and Black Caviar raced up, and she's gone past Hayless. Schofield had the full of whip. She's having a bit of a race, but Black Caviar is a length and a half in front, and the Wonder from Down Under wins again.
I just got to take my hat off to that mare. She's bloody wonderful, and she really toughs it out, you know. And you know, yeah, she touched me today.
Black Caviar being led round at the start. She's still the 6-1 on favourite. Moonlight Cloud at 5-1. There's a bit of money for Society Rock into 8-1 from 10-1. A nibble for Krypton Factor into 16s from 20s. Pastoral Player at 25-1. About 2.5 minutes to the official start time here. Won't be long before they're led round behind the gate. Black Caviar being taken behind the stalls. Looks like she might be loaded early here.
First, and of course she comes out first, and the jockey eases it back to come back to the others, and they're huffing and puffing trying to get to her, and of course she's phenomenal.
Just to repeat, she has won 21 races in a row. Every race she's won in, run in, she has won 11 of those at Group 1 level, but this is her first race outside Australia, and it's the journey here. It's the different situation, it's the different course, and it's everything associated with taking yourself halfway around the world that is her biggest challenge. And Peter Moody has made it very clear he doesn't think there's an awful lot to gain, there's everything to lose, but what there is to gain is a global standing, an international spotlight on her.
Most of the people that are here today, Claire, they want to see her. All the jockeys riding this race want to see how good she is.
And she's slotting into stall 15. She will be closest to the stand, so she could go all on her own, keep away from all the other runners if she wants to. She gets a friendly pat and a, you know, ruffle of the hair then from Glenn Darrington. And it's nearly time for the Diamond Jubilee, part of the Global Sprint Challenge. And we have a global sprinting superstar at the head of our market. She's going to go off an odds-on favourite, 6-1 on, and it's 5-1 bar. Society Rock last year's winner goes forward. Here's Jim.
Mama.
So here you go, Mike. Melbourne Cup is a race that stops a nation. This is a mare that has two nations agog. And there's the scene in Melbourne. Everybody watching. They're loading up the last few. Cheers from the crowd as Black Caviar is installed safely. A couple of them are getting restless. Moonlight Cloud is going to go forward now. This is her biggest challenge. Here at Royal Ascot, the Diamond Jubilee Stakes. Start a holding them. Society Rock is just rearing. A couple of them very edgy. They're racing in the Golden Jubilee. And Black Caviar's got away to a good start. Society Rock began badly. Sold is going to be the early leader. Out in the centre, Black Caviar travelling on the near side, getting a lead from Bogart. Out in the centre, Jimmy Styles, followed by Escalab. And further back then is Restia Dajon. Moonlight Cloud takes up a position in the middle of the field from the checker. Pastoral Player is further back in the field. They're followed then by Krypton Factor. Red Rock is out the back and company with Jenky. Then Serious Prospect, who's at the tail of the field as they race up now towards halfway. And Sol the leader from Bogart. And now Black Caviar rambling up on the near side. Shine in third. They're a link to Escalar, followed by Krypton Factor and Jimmy Stars and Restia D'Argent. And further back is Genki. But as they come up now onto the course proper, 2 furlongs left to go. Sol is the leader. Now Nolan starts to shake the reins at Black Caviar. She starts to move up on the near side. She draws level now with a furlong left to go. Now he says go on the mare. She gets about a half length in front of Sol. Restia D'Argent, Moonlight Cloud coming home fast, but it's Black Caviar in front with 100 yards left to go. Here's Restia D'Argent and Moonlight Cloud. He eases up near the line. Here's Moonlight Cloud. It's tight. Black Caviar and Moonlight Cloud in a photo. In third, then Restia D'Argent, followed by Sol. Further back is Krypton Factor, and that serious prospect back in the field from Society Rock. Bogart, the last to finish. He has eased near the line, and this is tight. This is very, very tight indeed. Black Caviar flashing home down the outside, Moonlight Cloud, as they race towards the line. Oh, she might have just got the bobbin. She's got there. She has scraped home. She has got there by a nostril. The winner is number 11, Black Caviar. The cheers.
I need you to talk me through how you saw that last half furlong, because I tell you what, it looked pretty nervous for most of us. What was your thoughts?
Oh, listen, I believe she was probably out on her feet a furlong and a half out. She never travelled as strongly and as keenly as she does at home. I probably had concerns a half mile out. I think only her grit and her ability and a great will to win got her home. And Luke was trying to look after her, so maybe he got caught short, but he got the job done.
Black Caviar had landed her 22nd consecutive race and took her winnings in prize money to nearly £4 million British pounds. But at what cost? It subsequently emerged the next day that she was very tender in her hind quarters. Those who watched Black Caviar in Melbourne's Federation Square on the day had absolutely no idea the pain barrier she was going through to land her famous success.
Black Caviar needs the line. He's easing up on her, and he's just scraped in. Oh, he did. He blew it.
There's confirmation that it wasn't just the jockey's performance that caused Black Caviar to scrape home at Royal Ascot at the weekend. The champion mare crossed the line injured. Insiders say Black Caviar tore muscles during the race, her 22nd consecutive victory. Europe correspondent Rachel Brown reports.
As dawn broke the day after the big race, the vets were already at work at the Newmarket Stables, checking on 2 muscle tears and severe bruising to Black Caviar's hind legs. Co-owner Colin Madden says the race really knocked her around.
She has a couple of minor muscle tears in hind quarters, and so they're letting her cool down and they'll reappraise her over the next few days. She's gone into quarantine because it was quite clear it was time for her to come back to Australia.
This is the moment that made millions of hearts race at Ascot and back in Australia.
Black Caviar's a length in front. She's hanging on.
It was her narrowest victory yet.
Black Caviar by a nose! She's crowned her career at Royal Ascot!
Immediately after, as post-race press conferences were held, celebrations were subdued. But ABC race caller Gerard Waitley believes the fact we now know she was injured makes the win all the more heroic.
Everything, it seems, went wrong. So when Luke Nolan eased up on her, he didn't expect her to stop virtually on the spot, and that's because she was in pain. So it will feel more rational in his mind now, the explanation as to why she did what she did.
And you would argue that these injuries now might actually prolong her career.
So rather than the immediate thought being that her brilliance is dulled and she's not the horse she has been, she's on the other side of the mountain, this is a plausible, tangible explanation as to why she didn't run in the same manner that we have seen in the past. She was injured. It's the second time in her career that she's had to dig in for the fight right at the end and try to win on heart.
You've only got to win by a quarter of an inch. That's what we're afraid to come here and win by, and we've got the job done.
disappear.